Hello friends, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to do a get ready with me with my current makeup bag. I thought it might be something that would be good to do like every month or so, so that I'm switching things up, but I'm also sharing with you, because I'm not doing favourites at the moment, sharing with you things that I'm really enjoying. So I did do a beauty haul last week, which you may have seen, and some of the stuff that I'm going to show you was in that. It's only quite new to me, but I'm really enjoying it so far. I also don't know what order in which these will go up, because I haven't filmed this haul yet, but these CUREL Hydrating, I've got the Water Essence and the Moisture Facial Milk. If you saw my empties, I was talking about the Skin Proud, I think it's called the Jelly Bright Essence, and that I was looking for something to replace that. Well, this absolutely does that job. The essence is just like an essence from, you know, any other essence you've tried on before. It's like a water-like consistency, and it goes on before your moisturiser, kind of like a toner, but it like locks in hydration. And then the Moisturising Facial Milk, this is the thing that is exactly like that Skin Proud. It's like a thin, like a liquid texture or a liquid formula moisturiser. Absolutely incredible. It feels like it makes my skin immediately plump, but it absorbs. Perfect for underneath makeup, especially if you are a little bit oily and you feel like you don't want to put a lot of stuff underneath your makeup. This is so, so nice. And it's on offer at the moment in Boots, which is when I'm filming this. So it must be new because I've never seen it before. But it is the perfect, perfect, I think, like transitional skincare. Spring, summer, whatever. So I've been putting this on underneath everything at night, but also underneath my makeup in the morning. It's ideal. The VICHY SPF is the one that I'm wearing today. Again, the texture is very, very fluid. It's always what I'm looking for, kind of like a thin, light consistency. I'll put more than this on, but a thin, light consistency that's not going to kind of interfere with the makeup that I put on top of it. I've been having a little bit of a tricky time with foundation recently and things like sitting right on my skin, whether it be like dryness or sinking into fine lines, whatever. So instead, I'm actually going to use a mix of these two correctors from Bobbi Brown. The ones I've got are Porcelain Peach and Light Bisque, and I'm going to just kind of dot them around. Light Bisque is kind of slightly pinkier, you can see it's this one, so this is nicer for underneath the eyes, whereas the yellowy Porcelain Peach is nicer for kind of like the rest of my skin. And this is nice. You know, just, I go through phases, and at the moment it's not the most flattering foundation for me. I'm probably not drinking enough water, but I'm just sparingly using these instead and trying to even out my skin a little bit. I've also been getting a little bit of redness and rashiness around my eyes, which I've mentioned a few times. A couple of people said that they thought it was, I want to say it was called periocular dermatitis, which, I mean, it could be, I don't know. I seem to have gotten a handle on the dryness, because it's almost like eczema that will come around my eyes. I seem to have got a handle on the dryness at this point, but I'm getting kind of rashes and redness still. So any advice on that, and I'm all ears, but I feel at the moment that I kind of want to pare everything down a little bit because I'm not sure what is causing that problem. And so again, minimizing the amount of like full face makeup that I'm doing, that's part of that. That actually blended out really nicely. It's kind of a dry consistency, that concealer corrector thing, but every time I use it, I'm surprised because it looks like it's going to be like a thick, creamy concealer, but it blends to be quite thin and flattering. I don't know how they do it, but it's great. Eye primer. So I'm going to try that Beauty Pie eye crayon again. I haven't used it since my first impressions video, but I want to try it and go a little bit heavier over the top an eye primer and see whether or not that makes any difference at all. The primer is the NYX HD. Which I've been using for years at this point. Speaking of NYX, I'm using the NYX Micro Brow Pencil in Taupe. I'll fill in my brows while I'm waiting for the primer to set a little I've actually been considering having my microblading redone because they're getting so pink. Like from a distance, they kind of look like they've got an orangey hue to them. And I was like, you know, I'll let them fade, it's fine. And they still give me shape to work with when I'm filling them in. But because I don't wear makeup every single day, it's kind of starting to annoy me a little bit. If I could just knock that like orangeness back a little bit, that would be great. But I don't think that I can. And the thing that's stopping me maybe having them done again is it going to happen again? Probably. Will this ever fade? I don't know. I kind of don't want it to fade completely because it still does give me shape to my brows where I had none. But at the same time, I'd like them to not be orange, you know? So the shade of the shadow stick is Brazillionaire. And I said in the haul, it's just not what I thought it was going to be. It's like a cool, kind of like a taupey brown, where I thought it was going to be a lot more bronze. I thought it was going to be a warmer tone, which it's not. But I'm going to see if over the top of a primer, maybe I can get a bit more oomph from it when I blend it out and see how well it lasts, because that's always the issue with a shadow stick. They tend to disappear on me or crease really badly, even over a primer. But I do like kind of cream products these days. As I blend it out, it does feel like it disappears a little bit. I'm gonna see if it sets, see if I can build on it. It's difficult because a cream shadow stick for me, in an ideal world, you wouldn't need to prime or anything. You just like whack it on, blend it out with your fingers and you're done. Of course, they don't work like that because they crease and disappear. But if they need the extra work of the primer, then I kind of want them to have something to them, you know? I've had this for a million years. This is the Clarins crayon in, what is that called? Intense Brown. It's rubbed off. I like it anyway. But it's got this handy little brush on the end for smudging. So I'm just going to put it on the outer edge of my lash. Not very much at all. And then smudge. I'm working today. It's not like a night out. But I'm just, you know, you want a little bit of definition. This was an immediate win from the haul. This is the Quick Color Contour Super Gel in Light. And I really, really liked this one. This was, I use one from Primark almost every day, but it's a lot, it's a very bold shade. Whereas this is much, much lighter, but still as easy to blend. And I mentioned in the haul, I think I did a comparison, I don't know if it was a full video or just a reel, but a comparison of the Primark one and the Charlotte Tilbury one, 100%. 100% preferred the Primark one for how it blended and like how evenly it looked. I mean, look at that. That, I love it. It's like the light version of the Primark to me. But it's got like a more of a gel consistency, which weirdly still blends really nicely. Whereas the one from Charlotte Tilbury, I find is patchy. This is just my new favourite thing. Sunkissed. I'm obsessed. Then the Beauty Pie Fresh Faced Super Cheap Blush, which looks crazier than it is. In fact, I think I'm going to do it with my fingers because it is, you see, it's like a muted, it's almost like a muted neon, corally type. And it gives that lit from within. I think it's the muted thing. It gives like a lit from within, like health. You know, the cheap products are definitely, definitely my standouts from the Beauty Pie haul. Tweezerman lash curlers, which every time I use them, I remember didn't want to use eyelash curlers because everybody told me to use eyelash curlers. This is a personality trait about myself. I do not enjoy it. If you tell me, ooh, you need to do this, I immediately don't want to do that thing. Will not be told. And I try and keep that in mind when someone recommends something and I immediately rebel against it because all of those years I should have been using eyelash curlers. And then the Lancome Lash Idole Mascara, which has been my go-to now for more than a year. I keep trying other ones and I just love this. And it lasts so long without like running out or drying out. I used to use the Lash Sensational Primer and Mascara. They were my like, that was my go-to combination. And they stopped making that Lash Sensational Primer. And if you actually added those two things up, it's not a million miles away from this. And this lasts overall about twice as long as those two did together anyway. So I kind of feel okay about the cost of this one. That said, it was sent to me. But I would absolutely purchase this with my own money. I was like literally had it in my basket to replace it the last time and it arrived in the post in another random like PR selection of things. So I know, but I promise I would pay for this with my own cash. Maybelline Fit Me Powder, which I'm just going to use sparingly to get rid of all of this shine. And then I think I'm probably, just like in these areas, I don't want to do the powder here. I'm probably going to use my Hourglass as well. So matte down the centre of the face and then the Hourglass, my beloved broken Hourglass. This is the Diffused Light. I'm just going to use that to kind of set the parts that I actually want to have a bit of a glow. I'm also going to do... I don't do that, you know, the... But with this, it feels different. It's a bit of a glowy something without a full-on shiny cartoon highlight. Do you know what? This also almost could be like a favourites of the month. Additional favourite is this. I bought two of them, the Nivea Tinted Balms. One of them is peach, one of them is watermelon. I've been saying for the longest time I'm looking for a balmy something with a hint of colour. If you swatch these, they don't look like much, but they are. They are. I think the peach is my favourite. They give me, and they smell amazing, they give me just a little bit of something. Lots of like lip balminess, obviously. Just a hint of colour. You see, it's not loads. It's not loads. And the darker ones, like I think it's like a cherry or something, gives you more. But I didn't want like a reddish pink hint. I wanted more of a peachy. And so this is perfect. I love it. Now, what I did last night was I tried to do a heatless hairstyle. It did not go well. So I've attempted to try and undo the disaster that was that. We'll see. Okay, this looks better. This looks better. I can live with this. This'll do, right? It's fine. Okay, we're done. So that's it. I'm ready. Thank you for joining me. Let's call this like current favourites. And would you be interested in like a frequent what's in my makeup bag? I watch so much. I said this at the beginning of the year. In fact, I think in the beginning of January, I did like what's in my makeup bag that was inspired by like the Vogue / what is it, Harper's Bazaar things where they're like, take off my makeup at the end of the day, go to bed with me. What's in my makeup bag? All that stuff, like how the beauty secrets, that kind of thing. I love those videos so much. And I feel like the style of them and the whole, beyond the fact that they all always feel like they're being sponsored by someone, it always feels like they're always like an ambassador for some brand, beauty brand. But the overall format of those, it feels like old school YouTube, like someone in a bathroom being like, oh, I use this all the time. I really, really enjoy this. This is how I do this. I really like it. Would you guys be interested in like a regular feature, like maybe once every couple of months or once a quarter of this is what's in my makeup bag, or this is, you know, get ready with me or go to bed with me, you know, because I really, really like that style. But yeah, let me know. Otherwise, thank you so much for watching, and I will list everything that I've used for you for your perusal down below. The links will be affiliate, which means I can make a small percentage of the sale if you were to purchase through them. If you do not want to do that, you can search for them yourself, whatever. So I'm not being paid directly by anyone to talk about anything, but I will be putting affiliate codes down there. So thank you. Bye.